Hey there, so if you are new to Qradar, okay, and if you want to set up a lab environment where you can practice things out, then you are at the right place, okay? So this is the first video in series of 3 or 4 videos, and in this first video, I will walk you guys through how to download and install Qradar Community Editions on VM in Oracle VM VirtualBox and in VMware Workstation, okay? Well, basically, I am about to share my findings of days with you guys because while I was trying to make things work, I had to face a lot of problems and I had to find a solution to each and every problem, but I wanted and decided to share with you guys so that it will be easy for you guys to get started with Qradar. Okay, so the first thing that you will need is that you have to download a Qradar.org file, and from here you can download it. Let me show you. So just open up any your favorite browser and just type Qradar Community Edition, okay, and then enter, and it will take you to this. And just click the first link, that is your IBM Security Qradar Community Edition, okay? So click the first link and then you will see here this, okay? It says that download Qradar Community Edition v7.3.3.3, okay? But before this, just if you can see this, it says requirements, so just click on these requirements and basically just make sure that you have these requirements, okay? Like it says that it has memory minimum requirement, that is 8 GB, and then disk space 250 GB and so on, okay? Now what you have to do is just click on this download Qradar Community Edition, okay? Click on this and basically it will take you to this. Well, if you already have an account, if you don't have an account, you have to create one, okay? And it's pretty straightforward. And if you have an account, you just have to log in and then you have to download the .org file. Well, I already had downloaded .org file, so let me go to the installation part, okay? So what am I gonna do next is let me open this Oracle VM VirtualBox manager, okay? And just you can see here file, click on this file and click on this import appliance, okay? And then you have to do what? You have to just click on this, okay? So click on this and you have to basically go to the folder where your .org file is located. So in my case, I know that it's on the desktop, so I'm going to the desktop, and this is actually the Qradar CE .org file. So I have to choose this, and in your case it might be in the download folder, so you have to just go there and just do it from there. So it's pretty straightforward. So just open it and then you have to do what, and then you have to click on this next, okay? And after this it says name, its name is VM. Let me change this, the name, let me give it the name Qradar, okay? And let me give it the RAM 10 GB, as I have a 16 GB RAM, so it will be okay for me if I assign it 10 GB RAM. So based on the availability, you can assign it accordingly, the RAM to this VM. So let me assign it let's say 10,000, right? And what you have to do next, just click on this import, okay? And then import. And it will take some time. If you want to install this Qradar on your VMware workstation, then how do you do this, okay? Open your VMware workstation, okay? Just click on this file and then you have to click on this open and you have to choose the .org file. So let me choose this and then open, okay? And after this, what you have to do is that you have to give it name, let's say Qradar, okay? And I'm gonna leave the password default, okay, and so on. It's pretty straightforward. You can do it yourself, okay? Everything remains the same, only this is, there's the difference, okay? So I'm gonna cancel it, okay? And I'm gonna go to the my VirtualBox, okay? So now you can see that it's here. So if I can click on this settings, okay, and let me show you something. Let me go to the network and make sure that this network adapter should be in the bridge adapter mode, okay? So okay, everything is just good. So just you have to start this VM. So let me start it, okay? Okay, so give the name root, okay? Root, and let me make it a little bit bigger so that you can view it. So let me, okay, so root and then enter, and it says you're required to change your password immediately. So let give it new password. Let is I'm gonna choose any password. and retype it. Okay, so make sure to remember this password. Okay, well, what am I gonna do next is I have to assign this static IP address. Okay, so the first thing that I will do is let me go to my CMD. Okay, CMD, right? Let me type it CMD here, and let me type the command IP config. Okay. So if you can see here, this is my IP address 192.168.100.100. So what I will do basically, I will assign a static IP address to my Qradar, and it should be in this range, okay? So how do I do this? Well, I will use a command, it's nmtui, okay? nmtui, and press enter, and press enter, okay? Edit a connection, and press edit, okay, and let us give it a good name, okay? So let us give it name, let's say ENP0S17, which is basically the interface name, okay? And then what I'm gonna do, instead of IP4 configuration automatic, I have to choose manual, to enter and manual. And what am I gonna do next? The show. Basically, you have to use the arrow keys, like up arrow, down arrow, and basically you have to select things out. Okay, so let me choose this address and just press enter, and then let me assign it IP address 192.168.100.720. Make sure that it should be in the same range as your window. Okay, then what you have to do is just provide the gateway. That is, if you see here, okay, you can check from here as well. That what is my gateway, okay? So look, it's your gateway 192.168.100.1. So you have to provide this gateway as well, okay? So 192.168.100.1, okay? And then you have to provide a DNS server, and let me provide the DNS server IP address, that is 8.8.8.8, okay? And what you have to do next is just scroll down, and for the IPv6 configuration, just enter and then ignore it, okay? And because I'm not gonna use it, okay? So what next you have to do is just you have to click on this okay, okay? So just okay, and then okay. So what you have to do is just go back, okay? And one more thing, that you have to change the name of your system, and it should be a fully qualified domain name, okay? That is FQDN. So let us set the system host name, okay? Enter, and let me give this a name, let's say qradar.tabi.com, okay? That's actually my fully qualified domain name, okay? So you can choose anyone, right? But it should be a fully qualified domain name, okay? So then what I have to do next is just okay, and again okay, and then you have to click on this activate a connection, and then deactivate it, and then activate it again, okay, and go back, and then you have to click on this quit, okay, and just clear you, so that we can see things clear. So if I type the command IP address, okay, and less, okay, I should pipe, and then less, okay. You can see here that my IP address is this one, 192.168.100.120, okay? So let us, okay, so Kim, and let us ping to the Google DNS server, and to check that whether we are able to communicate to the device on the internet or not. So let us verify it by ping, so 8.8.8.8. Good, so we are getting the reply. It means that we are ready to go. So, and if you type the command ls, you will see here setup. So we have to run this script, okay? So dot and forward slash setup, and just enter, and just you can see here at the bottom, press enter to accept these terms, or press control C. So I'm gonna press control enter, okay? And then you have to type the your space button, okay? So space button, okay? And once you are at the bottom, what you have to do is just press Q, okay? Q, and then you have to press enter, okay? And it says, do you wish to continue? Yes, of course we do. So yeah, why? And then enter, and it will take time, maybe 40 minutes or about 1 hour. So I'm gonna pass the video, and once it's done, I will be back, okay? Okay, so it took about 1 hour, and once done, you will see this. Okay, it says please enter the admin password. Well, basically, this is the user and password that you will use when you have to access the Qradar user interface, and we will do this in a minute. Okay, I have to provide the password. That is, let's say I'm giving the password, and make sure to remember this password. Okay. Confirm the password. Okay, so what will happen now? Okay, so let us check the status of Tomcat. So let us do by this systemctl, okay, and then status and then tomcat, okay. Well, it means it's running, it's fine, good, we're good, okay. And let me check what is the IP address. So IP address, and what am I gonna do, and less, okay. Okay, so what is my IP address? Well, this is my IP address, that is 192.168.100.120, okay. Well, let me check the IP address of my Windows, okay. So how do I check this? Let's say go there, and what was my IP address? Why am I doing this? Because I have to ping this, okay. I just want to check the connectivity, okay, because I have to access this from the Windows, okay. IP config, and it's my IP address is 100.100, okay. So let me check if I can ping to this IP address. So okay, so let us check, okay. So ping 192.168.100.100, okay. So we are getting the reply, and we are good to go. So now what you have to do is just open a web browser on your Windows, okay, and https and colon /// and 120. Well, basically this is the IP address of my Qradar, because I am going to access the user interface of Qradar, okay. So enter, and once it's done, you have to just click on this advanced, okay, and then you have to proceed, okay. And and by the way, let me tell you something, if you were not getting the reply, you have to wait for some time, right, because it's going to load the things, okay. So I have to wait, okay. You have to wait, okay, if you are not getting the interface, okay. So it's here, so you have to wait. Once it's there, you have to provide the username, and basically this is the admin, remember, and then it's the password, okay. So let me provide the password, okay. So let us click on login, okay, and it will take me to the user interface of the Qradar. So let's wait for it. Okay, so let us accept the license. Okay, so you can see that we have successfully accessed the user interface of the Qradar. But if you can, let us click on this log activity. Well, you can see that we are not receiving any logs, means there is no log activity, right? It's just empty. Well, this is because that we need to do some configuration, okay, and that's what I'm gonna do in the next video, okay. I will provide the link in the description, and or you can see it somewhere, it will pop up somewhere on the screen. So thanks for watching this video, and see you in the next video, okay.